The countdown is on. We're just hours away from the launch of NASA's next Mars rover, Perseverance. It was built right here at JPL in Pasadena, wrapped up and escorted by security to March Air Reserve Base.
So that's where it was loaded aboard a military C-17 Globemaster transport. Then it was flown by the U.S. Air Force over to the Kennedy Space Center. That's in Cape Canaveral, Florida, strapped onto a rocket and then rolled right out to a launch pad. And Perseverance won't just be studying the surface of our cosmic cousin. It's also carrying an aerial experiment that hopes to achieve a new first in flight.
Our special series continues with how the Mars helicopter Ingenuity could take space exploration to new heights.
Perseverance will be NASA's fifth rover to land on Mars, but aboard this robotic researcher will be a special soaring stowaway.
So we're carrying with us the Mars helicopter, Ingenuity.
Ingenuity helicopter will get to Mars riding along on Perseverance rover.
It's a counter-spinning dual rotor drone.
An experimental aircraft pushing the realm of possibility.
Almost cusp of feasibility, like really? Like, can you really do that? Can we build a vehicle that can fly in such thin air? And it has to be autonomous, you know, because it has to be operated from Earth. Can you pack in all of those capabilities in that tiny mass?
A steep obstacle of flight physics just to get off the ground.
Ingenuity required a lot of ingenuity for us to get together.
Even though Mars has lower gravity than Earth, its atmosphere is 100 times less dense, so that means you get 100 times less lift.
All of the rules about helicopters and the aerodynamics all had to be recast for us to make it fly in Mars in this very wispy atmosphere.
It's the ultimate engineer's dream job, I think.
Those engineers putting their knowledge, know-how, and even their fingernails to the test.
It's never been done before. Every incremental step leading up to that flight itself was really exciting or unnerving, nail-biting, you know what I mean? There were many of those incremental tests that we had to do for the first time and pass before you get to the first flight.
When Ingenuity does finally take flight, it will be a first for all of us.
It's first for NASA, in fact, first for humankind. As humans, you know, we've never flown a rotorcraft outside of our own Earth's atmosphere.
An aerial ability that once achieved will advance how we explore unknown worlds.
We can't reach like sites of cliffs, that they're very interesting regions that rovers can't reach to, and you know, it will let us get to places we can't get to.
Would be a tremendous plus for us exploring worlds that have atmospheres.
When you add that aerial dimension, that's how much richer, you know, we can, you know, enhance the space exploration. So that's what really drives us at the end of the day.
That and following in the footsteps of flight pioneers.
Of course, we are inspired by the Wright brothers, the American brothers that invented the first successful aircraft. We're shooting for a Wright brothers moment, but at Mars.
So if that soaring success wasn't enough, this Mars mission also aims to answer the big question of the ages. Are we alone in the universe? Join us tomorrow for the next episode in our special series, Scouring for Signs of Life, and how that discovery could rewrite history.
And if you're someone who wants to see the entire series so far, we've got you covered. Just go to KTLA.com and then put in /Perseverance.